Vietnam is the country with the most dynamic growth and economy in the entire Southeast Asia region. We have already talked about it in our first video of the series, so if you're new to the channel, go check it out. In this video, we'll focus on the sector of renewable energy, a segment of the Vietnamese market not to miss out. For further info, don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Talking about energy, we must talk first about its consumption. Consumption of electricity has increased by more than 11% per year, growing faster than the GDP of Vietnam. The country is Southeast Asia's second largest electricity consumer. Before we move green, it is fair to give a proper picture of Vietnam's power sector. Fossil fuels still dominate the market, with close to 56% of current installed capacity being coal, gas, and oil-based. Coal accounts for around 46% of Vietnam's electricity mix, making it the largest generator source. Hydropower represents the second largest share of installed capacity. It amounts to over 30% of the country's electricity mix in 2019. Meanwhile, just under 90% of capacity is based on gas. Though the country is seeking of renewable energy developers since 2011, Vietnam's renewable energy market only took off in 2018. Between 2014 and 2019, increasing industrialization and urbanization was followed by a shift in energy demand towards renewables, which brought Vietnam's power capacity from 109 megawatts to 5,700 megawatts. The second most important element of Vietnam's recent renewable growth is in its public commitment. A byproduct of Vietnam's economic boom was its massive carbon footprint and environmental pollution. Recent severe air and water pollution incidents in major cities have created public pressures that opposes any new development of coal power plants. Vietnamese people living in urban areas have been wearing their protective face masks long before the COVID-19 pandemic. Vietnam exploits all four big sources of renewable energy: hydroelectricity, wind power, solar power, and biomass. Our focus today is on solar power and wind power. Researchers have estimated that Vietnam would produce more than 16.5 gigawatts of solar energy and 11.8 gigawatts of wind energy. Vietnam's recent accomplishments in renewable energy have contributed to combat extreme poverty, both nationally and globally. With the help of a booming green energy market, the country's yearly poverty rate has been declining gradually. Vietnam has gone from a country with a rural electrification rate of 2.5% to being able to connect millions of rural families to the national grid, and the country is on track to provide more green energy to rural areas. Let's move on and see in detail how the aforementioned sources are performing in the country. Solar power is experiencing a golden age in Vietnam. Between 2017 and 2019, Vietnam deployed over 5.5 gigawatts of solar, amounting to over 10% of the power mix. By the end of 2020, the country's solar capacity reached 16.5 gigawatts. Additionally, the government of Vietnam is looking to install 12 gigawatts worth of onshore and offshore wind by 2025. This project includes wind farms in Binh Thuan, Bac Liêu, and Ninh Thuan, the latter being the largest solar farm in Southeast Asia. The success of solar energy in Vietnam can be attributed to feed-in tariffs, or FITs. The FITs encourage investment in renewable energy by guaranteeing a higher-than-market price for producers. As is typically engaged in long-term contracts, FITs help limit the risk associated with renewable energy production. In April 2020, the Vietnamese government set new FITs for solar, 10 months after the previous FIT program expired in June 2029. The new tariffs, compared to before, are between 10 and 24% lower and are still uniform among the regions, but differentiate by type: ground, floating, and rooftop system. It should be noted, however, that there are some deficiencies in infrastructure that hinder energy transmission. Most solar power plants are concentrated in the sunny southern region, where the national grid tends to be overloaded. At the same time, some solar plants have seen their operation delayed due to incomplete transmission line. Moving on to wind, here are some numbers. Vietnam's offshore wind capacity will increase to 36 gigawatts by 2045, accounting for 10.8% of the total electricity generation in 2045. Vietnam will have to invest $10 to $12 billion for the first 4 or 5 gigawatts of offshore power wind capacity. Meanwhile, the unit cost for 1,000 kilowatts of electricity generated by an offshore wind power farm is around $83, down from $2,055 USD in 2010. it is expected to further drop to $58 by 2025. With a coastline of more than 3,000 kilometers, low sea levels and high wind speeds, Vietnam is an emerging offshore wind power magnet in Southeast Asia. The Ministry of Planning and Investment is working with relevant ministries, sectors and localities to develop a national green growth strategy from 2021 to 2030 and the vision for 2050. To make Vietnam a zero-carbon economy as soon as possible, the strategic product sets goals on reducing greenhouse gas emission, greening all economic sector, promoting sustainable consumption and strengthening resilience during the green transition process, among other issues. At the 26th United Nations Climate Change Conference of the Parties, COP26, Prime Minister Pham Minh Chinh claimed that Vietnam's attendance affirms, once again, its commitment to cutting carbon emissions to zero by 2050. Measures to reduce greenhouse gas emissions have been widely adopted, with the results that these emissions decreased by 12.9% compared to the normal development scenario. Energy consumption per unit of GDP decreased by an average of 1.8% each year. There are still uncertainties regarding the future of coal. While PDP 8 emphasized sustainable development to tackle climate change, Vietnam's coal import in the first half of 2020 had a 53.8% increase over the previous year, a record high. The ministry expects Vietnam to face severe energy shortages as construction of new energy plants lags behind rapid growth in demand. Coal, therefore, continue to fill the energy gap over the next few years. However, there are signs of a decline in interest in coal. Most of the planned coal-fired power generation capacity has been delayed or postponed. Here at ICHAM, the Italian Chamber of Commerce in Vietnam, we always strive to give to our audience the best information regarding not only Vietnam's economy, but also about its opportunities for Italy. The two countries have signed an MOU on August 12, 2019, which aims to promote cooperation in the energy sector and follow the visit of the former Italian Prime Minister Giuseppe Conte in the Southeast Asian country, which took place on June 2019. The agreement lays the foundation for developing a fruitful collaboration between the two countries, in technical, scientific, economic fields, as well as in the energy sector, with particular interest in the development of liquefied natural gas, also known as LNG, a renewable energy. The goal is to strengthen the diversification of energy sources and increase energy security, always in compliance with the obligation deriving from national regulations, international treaties, and, as regards Italy, from those deriving from its membership of the European Union. The signing of the memorandum, therefore, allows Italy to develop energy cooperation with a country that plays a strategic role in Southeast Asia, thus opening up new opportunities for collaboration between Italian and Vietnamese companies. To maximize said opportunities, we at ICHAM are always here to support any company interested in the Vietnamese market and in its road to a greener future. ICHAM is pleased to support Italian companies by providing tailor-made B2B meetings with local buyers, helping Italy's presence in Vietnam. Did you know about the opportunities offered by the Vietnamese market? Will you take your chance in this country? ICHAM will be there for you. Grazie and hang up live.
Welcome to ICHAM Channel. The Italian Chamber of Commerce in Vietnam, ICHAM, is an agency that brings a bigger business network of the Italian company and the Vietnamese company, and also providing a customized experience and services to the company. Services of ICHAM are divided in following main categories. The first one and the most important one is market entry services. The second category is providing the consultancy for investment. The third category is organizing business networking. So if you have any requests or for further detail, please contact us. We are here to help. Thank you. Xin chào và hẹn gặp lại.